Yes, Presto has more than 250 instruction courses, papers, and video films at meetings around the world, in USA, Europe, Russia, Far East, in the last 10 years. Dr. Seras?
Yeah, Dr. Seras can say. Yeah, can you hear me?
Can you hear us?
Hello?
He'll be implanting a Zeiss MICS lens and he'll be using the Resalis 500 machine.
Okay, so this gentleman here has about a grade 2.5, grade 3 cataract, and I'm going to use this Visalis system, which has converted me from peristaltic in the last few months to a Venturi user. I never used to like Venturi machines because it didn't give me the kind of control that the peristaltic pump on the Infinity would give me. But with this machine, I've changed my mind. It gives a nice hold and works rather well. The trick to doing these cases under topical like this is to start paracaine 10 minutes before you put the patient on the table and not just put one or two eye drops when the time comes to operate the person. So what happens is that the conjunctiva and cornea and everything gets adequately anesthetized. Make a nice tunnel. I much prefer using diamonds because they give me a nice sharp and well-delineated corneal tunnel, which is less likely to leak, and you can make it the length that you want very easily. The next step is to do a nice rexis. And this lens is a plate haptic lens from Zeiss. So I would like to make like a 6 millimeter rexis like this. Whoops. Now notice rexis has run away. What do you do at this stage? Put some viscoelastic, and this is going to happen to all of us sometime or the other, however well practiced we are. Put viscoelastic where the rexis has tried to run away and simply pull it back in. And that's the end of it. So if your rexis tries to run away, it's not such a big deal anymore. Burp out some of the viscoelastic. I like to use viscoelastic from Zeiss. They have a dual system which has cohesive in the first part and dispersive as the second. Dispersive as the first part and cohesive as the second part. You can see the fluid wave going across. And this hospital is equipped with Lumera microscopes, which don't really let you see how hard the cataract is, because even a nice hard cataract has a nice red glow. But it's a visualization on a different level, and once you've used these Lumeras, you really don't want to go back to the old days. Now that I've tipped the nucleus up, you can see that it's not as soft as we thought anymore. And let's go to the phaco chopper. So we'll be using about 325 vacuum. I don't know if there's a, is there a feed?
Can you show the camera there?
Okay, that's fine. Okay, Shiva, look in the light, huh? Don't move. This is topical, so they're bound to feel a little bit of pressure. Suction, embed. I use continuous burst like this and get it in there. Then go from the side and simply approximate chopper and phaco tip. And you get one chop. Once you get one chop, then the rest of the cataract will obey you. And what I do in most of these slightly firmer cases is that I like to get one quadrant up like this. No, it's still one. And you can see that this cataract is being held by the posterior fibers. So you can split it apart like this. Can you see this? These are the posterior fibers. And it's holding the cataract together. So we try to split them and then the rest of the cataract will just meekly come out. Okay, go to 2 now. I don't think it's in focus. I'm just going to try to focus a little bit. Yeah, okay. Now with this mode, even the hardest nucleus you can easily remove. It's about 16 pulses. And how much vacuum am I using, Shiv Kumar? Okay. So with a Venturi system like this, you don't really need to use huge amount of vacuum because essentially pieces will come to you. And that's the attraction of using a Venturi. Always remember, if you're going to use a Venturi system, better make sure about two things. One, that the vacuum is set to nearly half of what you're using for peristaltic. And the second thing is that you have to have a good hydro dissection. If your hydro dissection is bad, you will pull everything. Remember, it will not distinguish between nucleus, cortex, or capsule. Okay, so once you make, stop putting water. So once you make sure that all the pieces are nice and discrete and separate, it's not a problem. But the trick with the Venturi is to get separate pieces and to make sure that nothing else is coming up towards the tip. You can see that they are rather firm pieces and don't want to break that easily. Okay, can we lower the vacuum? About 50 points? Yeah. So again, with a Venturi system, unlike a peristaltic, you have to learn to set your parameters correctly and lower it. Yes. So you'll be surprised that all the pieces will come to the tip and disappear like this. This is just 250 vacuum. And for the last piece, we go on to epinucleus mode, so that there's hardly any surge at all. And you can see slowly the last piece should go into the tip. So that gives us that element of safety. So now we are going to do a little bit of irrigation aspiration. Patient is a very nice gentleman. He's very cooperative. He's not blinking. He's not moving around. But typically with a topical case like this, you'll see the chamber valve go nearly flat like this. Shiva, look in the light, please. Go to IA, Shiv Kumar. Yeah, so only at the end we floor it and pull the piece in. So we start with low vacuum, hold on to cortex, and peel away from the equator and towards the center. What is the power of the lens that we'll be putting in today? 21.5. So it's a 21.5 lens. It's a Zeiss MICS lens. Aspheric optics. Now, I've been using these Zeiss lenses now for about a year or so. I routinely put in their multifocals and multifocal torics, and their calculator that they use is spectacularly accurate. So most of the time, there's very little or no residual left behind. They use some ray tracing method in their calculator that makes it rather accurate. You can see the Rexis is pretty good, in spite of it trying to run away at one point. So let's use some of Zeiss's Z Hyaline Plus. You can see that is the viscoelastic going in there. There you go. So it's nicely inflated now. And have a look at the lens. All the Zeiss lenses come like this. And they have this kind of haptics. Shiv Kumar, this one doesn't have holes. Yeah, because this is not multifocal. So whether you put it in this way or this way, it doesn't make that much difference. But this is the way the lens should go in. You just take it out, settle it in the cartridge like this. I like to load all my own lenses because otherwise sometimes there's always a little bit of a boo-boo. So So I much prefer doing it myself. Sometimes people give me a preloaded lens and it doesn't go in the eye the way I want. And this is their new ViscoJet 1.8 millimeter system. So you just load it up like this. And to know that everything is okay, you can see the lens there. You can see the plunger pushing it. So I go till it's near the tip, and then we wait. Center the microscope again. And as I said, these Lumeras have unparalleled visibility. There is no other microscope on the market that lets you look into the human eye like this. So once the eye is well filled up and bag is inflated, get this in there. In goes the lens. In. At the last moment, dip down like this. So at least only one leg will be left to go in. If you're lucky, sometimes both legs will go in and you won't have to do anything else. There's only one leg left and we are in. So this is basically the end of it, time to remove the viscoelastic. So we do some eye, go to visco mode, which is about 400. If you remember that I was doing most of the phaco at 250 vacuum, and that works very, very well because it's a Venturi system. What you can do is just burp out the viscoelastic like this. Most of it goes in one shot because it's a cohesive viscoelastic and sticks together like good friends. Okay, so now increase the vacuum. You can see there is no viscoelastic left. Believe me, with this microscope, if there was viscoelastic left, you would see it. Introduce the tip under the margin of the rexis, pushes out whatever remaining viscoelastic is there, and that's the end of it.
Lovely. Great work, Cyrus.
Thank you. Can I have some Vigamox? I always end by tightening up the side ports like this, because however well they are constructed, most of the time it's the side port that leaks. So hydration here, hydration here, and that's the end of it. You can see the chamber is very nicely maintained even when I take out the speculum.
That's nice. Very good.